a lesson, Health and Hygiene. In that video, we have learned about the components of the food. There are the 5 types of nutrients: carbohydrates, fats, protein, vitamins, minerals, and along with this, we need roughage and water. Am I right? Then we have discussed about the balanced diet. Then how to preserve the nutrient. Then we have learned about the diseases. We have learned the 2 main types of diseases, that is communicable and non-communicable diseases. Am I right? Now today we are going to our spread. How the communicable diseases are spread. The diseases are spread through air, through food and water, through insect, through direct contact. These are the 4 main types through which the diseases are spread. The first thing is communicable diseases are the diseases which are spread from one person to another. The diseases which are spread from one person to another is called communicable diseases. Am I right? Then we have learned the different types of the diseases in communicable diseases. They are spread through the microorganism. Am I right? So what is meant by the microorganism? The tiny germs. The tiny germs. Microorganism is what? The tiny germs. Now the diseases which are spread through air. Today we are going to discuss about the through air. Then the diseases which are spread by through air means what? By sneezing. Means when we are sneezing, while coughing. Am I right? While doing coughing, when we are not holding our hand in front of the mouth, the germs are spread out. Am I right? And when any other person comes in contact with that, he might get that disease. If he is suffering from sneezing, coughing, or common cold, then the germs comes out and they are spread to the healthy person. Am I right? The diseases to spread through the common cold, such as flu, common cold, coughing, tuberculosis, and etc. Then the next is the diseases which are spread through food and water. Now see, when the some foods we are eating, the street food. Am I right? You like more among the street food. Am I right? But whether that foods are kept properly, whether they are preserved properly? No, if the foods are kept open, then the flies, the dust particles which are in the air, they may come in contact with, the food may come in contact with that germs and they can spoil the food. And am I right? And if you will have that food, then just imagine what will happen. There will be the stomach. Am I right? Then suppose if the water, if you are not drinking the pure water or a clean water, then what will happen? Then again there may be some problem with that water. Means if we are not drinking the good quality of water or aqua water or clean water, then we can suffer with the following diseases. Then which diseases are spread through the food and water? Can you tell me? See, diphtheria, typhoid, jaundice, cholera, am I right? These diseases are spread through the food and water. Am I right? Then the next, the diseases which are spread through the direct contact. When any person comes in a direct contact with the healthy man, suppose if I am not feeling well and if I come in a contact with a healthy person and if I will touch them, or now see the corona disease. Am I right? The corona disease is suffering. The situation you might be knowing what is happening outside our world. Am I right? If we come in a contact with that particular person, then the germs may pass through us. Am I right? So that is the direct contact. So we are at home. Am I right? So we stay at home. So it is a need, today's need, that we have to stay home to be a healthy. So there is one slogan: stay home, stay healthy. Am I right? So to avoid this direct contact. Am I right? If that particular person, if the person is suffering from any disease, now the corona disease, am I right? If you will come into contact with that particular person or his clothes or his thing, then that germ may pass through us, am I right? So we should stay home, am I right? So stay home, everyone. So through direct contact, the diseases such as chickenpox, ringworm, measles, common colds are spread through this diseases when we come in a direct contact. And the last part of this is the diseases which are spread through insect. The diseases which are spread through insect. Now there are some insects. Now for example, mosquito. Am I right? The mosquito bite us. Am I right? From that, anopheles mosquito, when it is a female mosquito, when it bites us, then we can suffer from malaria. Then that has spread to the mosquitoes and malaria. And another the disease that is which is spread to the mosquito, that is dengue. This. Then the next is the diseases which are spread to the rat. Is the rat fleas, that is plague. So these diseases are spread to the insect. Then there are some MCQs related to this that we will solve here. The first is, what is the cause of a deficiency of vitamin A? That is, what will be the answer? Night blindness. So think of the night blindness. Then chickenpox, ringworm, measles are spread through which diseases? They are spread through direct contact. So think to them. Then the next point is how to prevent the communicable diseases. To prevent the communicable diseases, we should bath every day. We should take a bath every day. Then we should the house should be disinfected. The sun is the natural source of it. So because there should be a ventilation in our house, right? So the sun heat can make your house disinfected. Then the garbage should be thrown in the dustbin. The environment should be clean. The garbage should be thrown in the dustbin. The dustbin should be covered. You should cover the dustbin. Then the children should be vaccinated. The children should be given vaccination. In the small age, the children should be given the proper vaccination. So these are some prevention to overcome through the communicable diseases. So today's work is that you have to read the question.